Welcome back to a channel business. Today, we have really wonderful topic for discussing. We will address that what is research question, research gap, how research question is different from the research problem. So let us start this one. I would like to share the screen with you, my whiteboard, and I'm sharing my topic of today discussing. And I would like to show you here, today my topic is that basics of research gap, research question, and research problem. So outline, I would like to today discuss about that how you can identify the research gap and what is actually research gap, then the research question and what are the types of it. And finally, I will discuss about that research gap, research question, and research problem, how they are different from this other. So first, I would like to start now the research gap. So let me share here. Research gap. You can see here that I have write down the definition for you. So you are studying or you are working with some of the research paper, maybe the books, maybe thesis on the topic of your interest. And you have realized that, yes, there are some space, there are some provisions, there are some scope for my research, and significant scope. You have to remember that word, significant. Why significant? It has the importance for further research. That is, the researcher write down the research paper. He has done the research work, but you have find out that some of the areas are untouched by the researcher or by the author. So in that case, it is very, very important for you to utilize that research gap to formulate your research question. I would like to make it more simple. I would like to write down again for the research gap, okay? So in other words, what you can write down that no one has picked up or worked on these ideas. So the research gap, sometimes we are using as a literacy gap also. So these are the areas which are underexplored or unexplored. You have to understand that point. That is someone, they have not done any work in that particular area, or someone is doing, he is also finding out that, but he made no publication, there is no evidence that they have done some work in this area. So you can find out the research gap easily. Now I think one more point I would like to share so that it will help you to find out the research gap. Yes, we will have the more discussion, longer discussion about to find out how to find out the research gap for different research. But today I am giving you very basic point. That is, whenever you have find out that someone is not touching this area, they have left that part untouched, unexplored area. Now this missing piece or the pieces, in some cases, you want to go for this particular area. So how you will conduct the research? That you have to find out and you have to formulate that research question. So sometime it may be the population, maybe the sample size or the types of sample, location, maybe research method, whether you are qualitative research you are doing or the quantitative research. In both of the cases, there may be the scope to change the research method for better results. So you have to look into this point. And then there may be the data collection or the analysis process that they have done the data collection, but you are not agree with the analysis process. You are thinking like that, yes, there is a scope. There is a scope for data analysis in a better way that you are having some creativity in your mind and you want to implement your idea to find out the new findings in the research. So if I would like to simply conclude about the research gap, these are the areas or a particular area untouched by the previous researcher, the previous academicians. They are trying to find out the truth by systematic study, by doing research. But you have found out that some areas are missing, maybe unexplored or underexplored. And you have identified that one. Now you will formulate your research question in this research gap. Now, one question will be in your mind. That what is research question? Okay. I would like to write down this question and answer for you. Okay. And this is very, very important for you. And while you are starting your research, while you are preparing for if it is in India, UGC, NEET, then these are very important topics. Now you see that the research question, while we are discussing about the research question, then we have to address one issue or more issue by using this research question. So it is in your mind that whether the research question is the research gap? No. Because research gap will give you the opportunity to identify, to find out your research question. And you have to go through the analysis, interpretation of the data, each and everything by using your research question. So you have to keep clear in your mind, the idea should be clear that unexplored area, untouched area is the research gap. And there is a problem, there is an issue. And that issue you want to address with a research question. And sometimes again in your mind that whether the research question and the research problem will be same. I will also give some way on this point. But before it, I would like to show you some of the important part, that is the types of research questions, very important. And I would like to first go with the exploratory research question. I will write down the definition for you. So I use this one. You can see here that exploratory question. And you want to actually explore, okay? You want to explore something. This is, say, you are doing a qualitative research and you want to explore on a topic that this is how it is happening, you are interacting, then these are the exploratory research questions. So this is very easier part and always being popular with the research. Okay, then you can go with the predictive question. Yes, this is another part and the researcher are using this one. There is no actually term rule for defining directly the types of the research, that these are only the types, but in most of the cases, we are referring to different research methodology groups and different methodology books are giving us some idea about these types of research questions. So here, the predictive question, this is again, that you are doing some prediction about the future. It is not happening. You are going with this part. You are continuing your research to find out the truth in the future. You are making the hypothetical, that viewpoint from your side. And then you can adopt this type of research question. You have find out the research gap. Now you are formulating the research question and which may fall into this category. That is the predictive research question. Then one more type I would like to explain here, that interpretive. Okay, this is very interesting part. I would like to share with you. So in this research question, you will see here, I have write down and simplify the point for you. And you are gathering the feedback on a group behavior without affecting the outcome. You are never that directed the outcome, but you are gathering the feedback of the group behavior. You want to go for the necessary settings. That is, so interpretive questions that you can find out from the literature, and you can go through this research. So these are very interesting, and all are important, actually. We have to understand this part. Now, I would like to show you that another very simple, that very, very popular that research question type, that is the descriptive research question. Yes, descriptive research question always being followed by the researcher for their research, and they want to go for this one because they are having the opportunity for getting the data in a descriptive way. So they want to go for this one. And descriptive research questions are generally used to describe something, You want to describe some phenomena, maybe some issue, maybe some problem you are finding out from your side. And you have divided that problem into some questions. I will discuss it later on also about the research question and research problem and how they differ from each other. But right now, you have to understand that you can adopt descriptive research question also as the one of the method for formulating your research question. Now, another point I would like to explain here, and we have seen now it has become more and more popular in the research paper. If you are going to the publication of a job research paper, in most of the paper, they are using this part, that is the comparative research question, and they are having tendency to find out the comparison between the dependent variable or between the different study. And you can compare, the different study by formulating your research question, and you are finding out the new truth. So it is always interesting and most popular among the researchers. Now I would like to share that causal, yes, the cause and the effect. Okay, so let me share here that it will be really helpful for you. Well, so now you see that when you are doing your research to find out the relationship, you have to understand this part, relationship between the cause and the effect. Then causal research question you are formulating. And this is also very popular and important for the researcher. So what we come to know that there are different types of research question. And you can use the type of research question as per the demand of your research design. But the true fact is that we have to identify the research gap. That is the part no one is doing their work. Then after research gap, we can find out the research question. And as per the demand of our research design, we will go with a particular type of research question. And now you have to understand that research question is different from the research problem. In one research problem, there may be different number of the research questions. So these are very technical terms, and you have to understand. And I hope that you will really get more and more description about this topic, because in my upcoming videos also, I will explain about this again in an extended way. So regarding the hypothesis, formulation, each and everything, now hypothesis, alternative hypothesis, parametric, non-parametric test, how you have to conduct. So stay tuned with us, and please subscribe to my channel, and thank you for supporting us. Thank you very much. Thank you.